until the First World War, the market was dominated by British lines like White Star and Cunard, but increasingly they had to compete with German lines like Hamburg America or Norddeutscher Lloyd. White Star launched an ambitious project to replace its older liners, which dated from the previous century, with ships that would be larger and more comfortable than any other before. And this is why the Olympic class, that included the Titanic, was designed. They had to be more attractive than all older liners, larger, and they had to embody the kind of European luxury that wealthy Americans looked for, because in first class they would be the majority of clients. The competition to offer larger, faster, and fancier ships had begun earlier, in particular in the first decade of the century. The main British competitor, Cunard, had launched two liners, the Lusitania and the Mauretania, that were on top of this game. But the Olympic and the Titanic were designed to outdo them. So the project was started in 1907, and the two ships were built in Belfast, in Northern Ireland. There were slight differences introduced to make construction a bit more economical or to improve performance, but overall, the three ships, Olympic, Titanic, and Britannic, looked very similar.